Hello everyone and welcome to the next session of videos for XML. Now in these videos we are discussing about the basics of XML, what is an XML, the introduction to XML, and these videos are also helpful for examinations like PGT computer science as well as for UGC NET, because in UGC NET also they are also asking questions from XML, that is Extensible Markup Language. So as you can read here, what is the full form of XML? So XML stands for Extensible Markup Language, and it was designed to be both human and machine readable. And XML is a software and hardware independent tool for storing and transporting data. So what exactly is XML? What do you understand by this is that assuming that we have one system here and we have another system here, okay? Now generally what used to happen is when you used to transfer data from this system to this system. Now when I'm saying system, it can be anything. It can be related to a computer system, it can be related to some kind of databases, it can be related to some, you know, online web pages or extra, I mean different kinds of systems are there. Now we needed some language so that if we transport data from one place to another place, now that data should be readable in both the places exactly equally. I mean the data should not change, and both the places should know what is the kind of data that you are transmitting and what are the elements in that data. Don't worry, I'll take one example to explain this in more details. Let us just go through about the basics of XML. Why do we study it? So XML plays an important role in many different IT systems. Generally, if you see the basic databases, even the software like databases, they are also implemented by using XML in the initial phases. So I remember that when I was doing my master's, that is M.Tech, during that time, my project was to design a database. And to design the database, we have to store different elements of the database. And to store the elements, we used to create XML files. So it was very simple that what we have done is we created a database management system. Now in that database management system, let us say you want to create a table. Now in that table, we were having different attributes. Now for all those attributes, we created a tag in XML. Now this way we can store various information in the table in the database, and whenever you want to read some data from the database, you can read according to these tags. So you can read the data which must be included between two tags, and accordingly you can read and modify information in the database. In the same way, in the internet, whenever you are passing some information from one place to another place, you need to tell what is the kind of information that you are passing, and according to that kind of information, you have to notify the elements of that information on the sender side as well as on the receiver side. For example, let us say I am writing an email. So in an email, we'll be having a field which is called as to, we'll be having a field which is called as from, we'll be having a body of the email. Now these to and from and the body, they should not change from one place when the data is traveling from one place to another place. In both the places, when they are going to read the data, these to, from and body, they should clearly know what is the field. I mean to, there's an email address here, there's an email address here, so the receiver should also understand properly what is the fields are there in the information. Now for that purposes, you have to organize and arrange the data. We created something called as XML. So XML itself, it doesn't do any important or meaningful task, but rather just give the structure to the data. So it is just a tagging language to give the structure to the data. So we'll read that later point of time, you'll understand what I'm trying to say here. But it gives a structure. So it is important for all types of software developers to have a good understanding of XML, because mostly whenever you are going to generate or develop, that is web-based software where you have to pass information from one place to another place, In that case, you are going to require, you are going to need a knowledge of XML, because without having that knowledge of XML, you will not be able to make that meaningful softwares or the tasks. Don't worry, we'll look at it. So what we will understand, or what we will do in these lectures, number one is we are going to study what exactly is XML, how does XML work, how can we use or I use XML on various portions during our development phase, or what can I use XML for. So we are going to answer these four questions one by one. So the very first question that is important is, what exactly is XML? Because that's the most basic question which most of the students, they are asking, what exactly is XML? Sir, I'm reading XML, then what is XML? So as you say, XML is a markup language same as HTML. Just like HTML, XML is also a markup language. And XML was designed to store and transport data from one place to another place, as I told you. So HTML, the full form HTML is hypertext markup language, and full form of XML is extensible markup language. As you can clearly know, see, XML is extensible markup language, okay, and HTML is hypertext markup language. Hypertext markup language. So when the name suggesting XML, they both are markup languages, but XML means, extensible means, there are some extensions to the markup tags that we are using. So you can say this XML is like, not exactly, but like an extension to HTML. So it is like an extension to HTML. So it is just like an extension to HTML. Now this XML was designed to store and transport data. And how we are going to store and transport data? By giving structure to the data. By giving structures to the data. Structure. That is how you are going to store various kind of information. That is called as giving structure to the data. And XML was designed to be self-descriptive. So what do you mean by self-descriptive? Actually, when I will just take an example of an XML tag, you'll understand what exactly is self-descriptive. And this XML is a W3C recommendation. W3C recommendation. What is actually this W3C? So W3C is a standardization organization. The full form W3 is a World Wide Web Consortium. So it is World Wide Web Consortium. So you should know this kind of full forms, because they generally ask these kind of full forms in your computer literacy, or sometimes they are also asking, they'll also ask you the full form of W3C. In many examination we have seen that. So there are various levels of recommendation. So this is a W3C recommendation. What do you mean by this W3C recommendation? It means the XML, if XML is a W3C recommendation, that means this is the most mature stage of development. At this point, the standard has undergone extensive review and testing under both theoretical and practical conditions, and the standard is now endorsed by W3C, indicating its readiness for deployment to the public and encouraging more widespread support among implementers and authors. So if something is W3C recommendation, that means has gone through extensive research, extensive review, and extensive testing. So, as you can see here, it is tested both in the theoretical concept, I mean theoretically how it should work, and at the same time it is also tested practically, that means practically how it should work. So XML is again a W3C recommendation, that means there's extensive research has already done in XML, and people are extensively using XML to transport information from one place to another place. Now this XML became W3C recommendation in early February of 1998, and then it got recommendation from W3C. So what exactly is the XML? Again, XML does not do anything meaningful, but all it creates is give a structure to the document and wrap information in tags. So XML is just information wrapped in text, and someone must read a piece of software to send and receive and store and display it. So there's, you have to write a piece of software to read the data from the XML. Just for example, let us say we have to send a note from Himanshu to Himanshu from Digimento. So this is the XML tags and the code for this. As you can see, these tags are not actually predefined tags. The tags here are not predefined. Okay. So here we have a note starting and ending tag. That is a note is starting here, ending here. We have two, that is the information to the people, person who to whom you are sending the information will be between these tags. From that, who is sending the information will be between these tags. Heading, what is the heading of the document is written between these tags, and the body of the document will be written between these tags. So what will happen is on the sender side, so let us say sender is maintaining some maybe a table or some kind of information. Now sender needs to send this information to the receiver. Now in that way, sender is going to create some tags like this so that receiver will understand that whatever is written between the two tags should be the person to whom you are sending the message, and whatever the information is written in this from tag should be the person from whom this sending message has came from. So this tags, I mean, on the receiver side as well as on the sender side, they both need to have some kind of software which reads all this note, which reads all this tag, and it should be able to find meaningful information by reading these kinds of tags. And these tags are actually user defined, they are not fixed tags. For example, whenever when you studied the HTML, you have checked that in case of HTML documents, all the tags are predefined. For example, you have href for the links, you have italic I, you have bold B. In the same way, there are many tags, hundreds of tags that are predefined. So you don't define your tags, you just use the predefined tags to give structure to your document. But in case of XML, these tags, the user is having the power to create the tags, and accordingly, if the user is creating the tag, then he also have he should also write the software to read the information from this tag. So just like it is just giving telling us giving a structure so that whenever the receiver is going to receive the information, he should read the information between the tags and he should be able to find meaningful information from this. So as you can see, the above tags that is created by you or your software developer. So this above tags are self-descriptive. It has a sender information, it has a receiver information, it has a heading, and it has a message body. That means sender who sent the message, receiver who is going to receive the message, what is the header of the message, and what is the body of the message. So all this information can be noted from the above tags itself. Okay. So what does XML make? What is the difference between XML and HTML? So again, XML or HTML were both designed for different goals. HTML was designed to create layout or structure to web pages. So it is just for design to create structure and layouts of web pages for websites. But XML is designed to transport data. And XML was designed to carry data with focus on what data is, what kind of data you are sending. So that is the main focus while designing XML. And HTML was designed to display the data. So XML is again, it is designed to carry the data, and HTML is designed to display the data with focus on how data looks. Here, how data looks, and there the focus was what data is. So this is an important thing. So you should know XML is designed to get data with a focus on what data is. HTML designed to display the data with a focus on how data looks. And XML tags are not predefined like HTML tags. So you have the power to create these XML tags. But in case of HTML, all the tags are already created. Now, XML does not use a predefined tags as we have already seen. So tags in the previous example, like is to tag and from tag, are not defined by XML standards. So these tags are invented, as we have written, invented by the author of the XML document. For example, if I am the author, then I can invent my tags. I can say there's a tag which is ABC and there's a closing tag of ABC. I can say there's a tag which is Himanshu and the tag closing tag of name Himanshu. So I can wrap some information between these tags, and when I'm going to send these tags to the receiver, now receiver should be able to read these tags to find meaningful information. And to read this tag, receiver has to write its own piece of software. So as you can see, HTML works on predefined tags like P, H1, table. So P is for paragraph, H1 is for heading 1, and table is for creating the tables. With XML, the author must define both the tags and the document's structure. So we have to define what are the tags that we are going to use and how we are going to structure the entire document. So what is the benefit of using XML? So XML simplifies the data sharing. Obviously, it is designed to send the data, so it simplifies the data sharing. It simplifies the data transport, how the data is going to be transported. It simplifies the platform changes. It simplifies the data availability, how the data is available in both the ends. So these are the main goals of XML. Right, now many computer systems contain data in incompatible formats. Now exchanging the data between the incompatible systems of an upgrade system is a time consuming task for both web developers. A large amount of data must be converted and incompatible data is often lost. So let us say this is the sender, and sender is sending some data on some format, and this is the receiver, but receiver is not having the same kind of format. So obviously receiver is going to either miss some information or it will take wrong information. So both sender and the receiver, both of them should follow the same kind of standards. Therefore, both of them should follow the same kind of XML tags, and they should be able to find out what is the kind of information that the sender is transmitting. Doesn't matter that in an email, whether you are writing from first and to later, or you are writing to first and from later. So that should not matter. The only thing that matters is that you should clearly specify from whom the email is sent and from and to whom the email is being sent. Now this XML stored data in the plain text format. It provides a software and hardware independent way of storing and transmitting and sharing the data. And XML also makes it easier to expand or upgrade to a new operating system, new application, new browsers without losing the data, because you can upgrade it, right? But we are not reading the data according to the operating system design. We are not reading the data according to the application. We are sending the data according to the kind of information that the data is having. Now with XML, data can be available in all kinds of reading machines like people, computer, voices, etc., etc. All kinds of format we send data. So even if you have studied this RSS feed, now this RSS feed is also sent in the form of XML. So XML is just like creating a structure to send the data. Right. So that was just a very simple introduction to XML. I hope that you learned from this lecture. But this was just an introduction to XML. Let us look, let us take some more examples in XML and study this XML in more details. And thank you so much for